الحمد لله رب العالمين يا رب لا تؤمنا مكرك ولا تولنا غيرك ولا تنزع عنا سترك ولا تنسنا ذكرك ولا تجعلنا من الغافلين أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له خلق فسوى وقدر فهدى وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه الرحمة المهداة والنعمة المسداة والصراط المستقيم اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وأنعم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه حق قدرهم ومقدارهم العظيم وارض اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء سيدنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وارض عنا معهم يا رب العالمين آمين ثم أما بعد My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, it is my honor to welcome you all to the Fariida of Jumu'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, guide our hearts so that we can listen to the sermon that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we may follow the best of it. وَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِي الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ My dear brothers and sisters, we have seen what happened in Palestine, in Al-Aqsa during Ramadan, and what had happened after that. And lest we forget, It's gonna happen again, since there is no solution for the problem. It's gonna happen over and over. Since there is no diagnosis for the disease, we're gonna keep suffering from that until the treatment has been prescribed. So that is the reason when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the Sahaba were defeated in the battle of Uhud and the Muslims start asking themselves why this happened Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran to say to them and to us as well أَوَلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَدْ أَصَبْتُمْ مِثْلَيْهَا قُلْتُمْ أَنَّا هَذَا قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ Whatever happened to you, it is because a reason. And the reason is because you declined to follow the guideline that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by which guaranteed for us to have the upper hand, to be effective, to be a nation that has a value. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in the Quran, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس You are the best nation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought up for mankind. And we say we are the best. We are the best. And the word kuntum means you are in the eyes of Allah. as believers to be the destination. Allah has decreed that preference for you. But that status of the Muslim Ummah cannot come out of the blue. You have to fulfill the condition to be the destination. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. That status of yours to be the destination is because you are a nation that should command what is right, enjoin what is right, and forbid what is wrong. If you do that, you are true believers. Does that mean there are believers by wishful thinking? Yes. People dream who are the best. And let us not forget that the Christians said the same thing. And the Jews said the same thing in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Surah 5, verse 18. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ وَالنَّصَارَى نَحْنُ أَبْنَاءُ اللَّهِ وَأَحِبَّاءُهُ. They said the same thing. We are the chosen people by Allah and the most beloved one to Him. وَقَالُوا لَنْ يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَ هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا. No one to go to heaven but the Christians. That's what they said. And the Jews said the same thing. No one to go to heaven but us. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, answer that dream of theirs, بَلْ أَنْتُمْ بَشَرٌ مِّمَّنْ خَلَقٌ. There is no one to be the best in the eyes of Allah, just for guaranteed. No. And Allah says, فَلِمَا يُعَذِّبُكُمْ بِذُنُوبِكُمْ. Why did Allah punish you for your sins? Does Allah punish the people He loved? No. This means you have to re-evaluate your status. You have to reconsider what you are doing. Otherwise, you are a bashar, just a creation from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. Same thing is true with the Muslim Ummah. We are the best. Allah gave us everything to be the best. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the Quran, the everlasting divine revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that no one can corrupt. Not because we are doing a good job, no. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guaranteed that for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikr wa inna lahu lahafidhun. Because Allah guaranteed that the Quran is the last book, must stay intact till the end of the time. So what is wrong with us? Why this happened? The reason is because we don't value what we have. We take Islam only in the masjid. We are so bragging, proud about the way we do salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribe salah only 5 times a day. If you pray 1 million times and you are doing nothing outside, there is no effectiveness, there is no good economy, there is no development, there is no advancement in science, in medicine, in engineering, in military arms, there is nothing. What kind of religion? What kind of relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So that is the reason when a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asked him, Ya Rasulallah, did Allah command you to command us to pray 5 times a day? He said, yes. No more than that. He said, no more than that. unless you volunteer, kept asking about fasting, about Hajj. Then the man said, Wallahi, la azid wa la anqus. 5 times I'm going to stick to that, even only fard without sunnah.